Welcome to Well Explained. Today I am here with Class 9 Maths, Chapter 1 Real Numbers, Exercise 1.3. Students, question number 1 of this exercise is, write the following in decimal forms and say what kind of decimal expansion each has. The first one is 36/100. As you can see in this rational number, the denominator is 100, and you have learnt in previous classes that whenever the denominator is having zeros, you can directly convert it into decimals by counting the number of zeros and putting it in front of the digits. That means here are two zeros, 36, moving towards left, 1, 2, you will put a 0. And the number will become 0.36. The other method is dividing 36 by 100. As 36 is smaller than 100, you will put a decimal, putting a 0 here. 100 threes are 300. 60 will be the remainder, then 0, and 6 are 600. After the two steps, you will see that the remainder is coming 0. So whenever we divide a numerator by a denominator and the division is completed by leaving a 0 as remainder, so the decimal expansion is said to be terminating decimal expansion. So we will write it has a terminating decimal expansion. Clear to all of you? Now for the second one. It is 1/11. For converting it into decimal, what will you do? You will divide 1 by 11. 1 is smaller. You will put a decimal 0. And you see that the 10 is also smaller than 11, you will put a 0 and one more 0, 11 nines are 99. 1 is the remainder, then you will put one more 0 because of decimal. 10 is smaller than 11, you will write 0, 0, and then again 11 nines are 99. 1 is the remainder. You will see that this division is repeating. That means we got remainder 1, we took zeros because of decimal and by putting 0, and then also the remainder 1 is coming. So the decimal expansion of 1/11 is 0.0909 and so on. It means it will never end. We can also write it as 0.09. As 09 both the digits are repeating, we will put a bar above 0 and 9. So this type of decimal expansion is known as non-terminating. It has a non-terminating repeating, because 09 is repeating, so non-terminating and repeating decimal expansion. Now the third question is 4 whole 1/8. We will convert it into rational number like this. This will be 33/8, and when we will divide this 33 by 8, we will get 8 fours are 32. 1 is the remainder, we will put a decimal 0, 8 ones are 8. 2 remainder, we will get a 0, 8 twos are 16. then 4 will get 0, 8 5 is the 40. You will see after few steps the remainder is 0. So in this case the decimal expansion of 33 upon 8 or 4 whole 1 upon 8 is 4.125, which can also be written as it has a terminating decimal expansion. Now the fourth question. Fourth one is 3 upon 13. You start dividing 3 by 13 decimal 0. You will get 13 twos are 26. What will be here? 4 will be the remainder. We will take a 0. It will become 40. Then 13 threes are 39. What is remainder? 1. You will get 0. But 10 is smaller than 13. You will put a 0. Here also a 0. And then 13 sevens are 91. 9 will be the remainder. You will get a 0. Then 13 6 is 78. The remainder will be 12. You will get 10. 13 9 is 117. Then 3 will be the remainder. And you can see now 3 is the remainder. That means we started with 3 and again 3 is there. So after so many steps, the division is repeated. So we can write it as 0.230769 and so on. Means what is repeating? 230769, then again 230769, and again so on. So you can write it as 0.230769 bar. So it has a non-terminating, because the division is not ending, non-terminating and repeating, because these digits are repeating after a certain interval of time, the repeating decimal expansion. Clear to all of you? Now coming to question number 5. Part 5, 2 upon 11. So we will start divided 2 by 11, 0.0, 11 ones are 11, what will come? 9, then 0, 11 eights are 88, then again 2, we started with 2 and the remainder is 2. That means after this, the division will be repeated again and again. Can write it as 0.1818 and so on. It can be written as 0.18 bar. It has a non-terminating and repeating decimal expansion. The last part is 329 divided by 400. Okay, we'll divide 329 by 400. 329 is smaller than 400. We'll put a decimal, take a 0. 400 is the 3200. 990 is the remainder. We'll take a 0. 400 is the 800. Then 100 is the remainder, we'll get one more 0. 400 twos are 800. Then 200 is the remainder, we'll take one more 0. 5s are 2000. And you will see at the end what is coming, remainder is 0. That means this can be written as 0.8225. That is, it has a terminating decimal expansion. You have to do work like this only. You have to show the divisions as well as the, you have to tell the kind of decimal expansion each has. Now in all these examples, rational numbers are expressed into decimal form and the division process comes to an end without leaving any remainder. In which examples? First, third and the sixth one. The division comes to an end without leaving any remainder, that means remainder is zero. So such type of decimals are called as terminating decimals, and since the number of digits after decimal is finite, that means in this case the number of digits are 2, means you can count them. Finite means that can be counted. Here there are 3 digits and here there are 4 digits after the decimal. So these numbers are also called as finite decimal forms. Now question number 2. You know that 1 upon 7 is equal to 0.142857. Okay. This is given to you. Now what you have to do is, can you predict what the decimal expansions of 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 7, 6 upon 7 are without actually doing the long division? And if you can predict, you have to tell if so then how. Agar kar sakte ho to kaise? Yes, we can predict. The answer is yes, we can predict the decimal expansions of 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 7, 6 upon 7 without actually doing the long division. Now I'm going to tell you how. Okay. We have given 1 upon 7 is equal to 0.142857 bar. Bar means all these numbers, 6 digit after the decimal, they are repeating. Now, we can write 2 upon 7 as 2 into 1 upon 7. Okay. We know the value of 1 upon 7 is 0.142857. Clear? And when we will multiply this 0.142857 by 2, we will get 0.285714. Okay, so this is the value of 2 upon 7. Similarly, for 3 upon 7, we can write it as 3 into 1 upon 7, 3 into 0.142857. And when we will multiply these two numbers, we will get 0.428571 and bar on all the 6 digits. For 4 upon 7, we can write it as 4 upon 7, 4 into same number 0.142857, and we will get 0.571428. Okay, for 5 upon 7, we will get 5 into 1 upon 7, which is equal to 5 into 0.142857, which is equal to 0.714285. And similarly for 6 upon 7, we can write it as 6 into 1 upon 7, which is equal to 6 into 0.142857, which is equal to 0.857142. Okay, now question number 3. We have to express the following numbers in the form P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So our first number is 0.6, and you can see it's a bar on the number 6, means digit 6. Bar is having, that means 6 is repeated. This is the decimal expansion, and we will assume that let x is equal to 0.6. We'll remove the bar, that means 6 is repeating. Okay, this is equation 1. Now, as 6 is repeating, only one digit is repeating, what we will do, we will multiply both the sides, that means LHS as well as RHS by x. Multiplying both sides by 10, what we will get? 10x is equal to, when we will multiply this by 10, this decimal will be shifted to right side, one digit, because it is having 10. So this will become 6.666 and so on. Let it be our equation number 2. Now the next step is, we will subtract the equation 1 from the equation 2. So subtracting equation 1 from equation 2, we get, what do we get? Like 10x is equal to 6.6666, x is equal to 0.6666, and we will put a subtraction sign. This will be 9x is equal to 6 misses 0, subtract ki to 6 point, and as these after decimal the digits are same, it will become 0. X is equal to 6 upon 9, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 3 2s are 6 and 3 3s are 9. It will become 2 upon 3. So the rational number for decimal expansion, 0.6 bar is 2 upon 3. Now coming to the second one. Second one is 0.47 and the bar is only on 7. First of all, we'll write, let x is equal to 0.4. 4 is not repeating, only the digit 7 is repeating. We will repeat 7. Let it be our equation number 1. As digit 4 is not repeating, and while expressing the decimal expansion in rational numbers, what we have to do is, we have to equate, means after decimal the digits should be same. What we'll do, only one digit is not repeating, we will multiply both the sides by 10. Multiplying both sides by 10, what we will get, this decimal will be shifted to this side, we will get 10x is equal to 4.777. Okay, let it be our equation number 2. Now we will look at the two equations. In the first equation it is 0.47 and in the second equation it is 4.7. That means after decimal they are not same. So what we will do, as one digit is repeating, we will again multiply it by 10. Multiplying again both the sides by 10, we will get 10 tens are 100x is equal to, now this will be shifted to this side, it will be become 47.777 and so on. So this is our equation 3. You can say here be point ke baad 77 or either be point ke baad 77. Now the two decimal expansions are same. Okay. Now we will subtract second from third, not first from third. We will subtract second from third. So subtracting 2 from 3, we get, what do we get? 100x is equal to 47.777. 10x is equal to 4.777. Subtraction sign. This will be 90x is equal to point ke baad to 0 ho gaya kyunki digits are same. Number is same. 47 minus 4 is 43. So x is equal to 43 upon 90. This is the answer. Okay. Now the third number. Third is 0.001 and bar is of all the digits after the decimal. So let x is equal to 0.001, 001, 001 and so on. This is our equation 1. As the 3 digits are repeating, we will multiply both the sides by 1000. Multiplying both sides by 1000, what we will get? 1000x is equal to, this decimal will be shifted to three places towards the right. It will become 1.001, 001, 001 and so on. Now subtracting 1st from 2nd, we will get 1000x is equal to 1.001, 001, 001 and so on, and x is equal to 0.001, 001, 001 and so on. When you subtract, you will get 999x is equal to 1. X is equal to 1 upon 999. This is the answer. Now question number 4. Express 0.99999 in the form P upon Q. Now when you will convert it into in form of P upon Q, that means of rational numbers, they are asking, are you surprised by your answer? And you have to discuss it with your teachers and classmates. So let x is equal to 0.9999. It is given. This is the first equation. As one digit is repeating, we will multiply both sides by multiplying both sides by 10. We will get 10x is equal to, this will be shifted, 9.9999 and so on, the equation number 2. Subtracting 1st from 2nd, what will you get? 10x is equal to 9.9999. X is equal to 0.9999. When we will subtract, what we will get? 9x is equal to 9.0. That is, x is equal to 9 upon 9. That is 1. This is the answer. Now, you will say 0.9999. How come it is equal to 1? Since 0.9999999 means it goes forever. It's up to infinity. So there is no gap between 1 and 0.9999... and hence they are equal. Okay. Since there is 0.9999, it goes for forever. Okay, so There is no gap between 1 and 0.9999. Hence, they are equal. Clear? Now, from question number 5, we will resume the next class. That's all for this class. Have a nice day. Stay blessed.